the theme, I guess, is mostly just that it's all figurative and there's a lot of flesh. And it's not, when I say that, it sounds kind of dirty, and it's not at all. But it's just that, you know, I have had a lot of models over, and I really didn't realize it until actually I put it up on the wall. And to me, it's a real struggle to get the flesh tone and get that. You know, and some people do it, and I just wanted to really work on that this time and really focus on that. Other than as far as subject matter, they're kind of just snapshots. So the only thing that really ties them together, I think, are the figures and the flesh. Yeah, this is Lady Godiva Rides again. This is called Intervention. This is Proliferation. This is called Royal Educt. And this is the first one of all these that I did. For some reason, I started, ducks have started popping up in my paintings, and it turned into to be about like right to life and our whole society and everything. It's all wrapped up about the eggs and the sanctity of life, and so kind of created this little tableau about that using ducks. People want to know what the stories are about sometimes. Now, I don't think of them as stories in terms verbally. I mean, usually when you think of stories, you tell stories speaking or reading or writing. And that's, as I'm putting together the narrative or the stories, I don't think of them as like a once upon a time, this, you know. And it's not until afterwards that I'm forced to put words to them. On my sketches, I don't really take them beyond this. I'll go right from the sketchbook pretty much to the canvas. And, you know, these make all perfect sense to me. I know they just look like scribbles to you, but I know exactly what each of these would be, and I can sort of see. So at this point, I'm just trying to, you know, work out different compositions, and they don't always make sense. You know, at this point, I'm just trying to come up with ideas. Yep. So this is the initial sketch for Godiva Rides Again. You know, this was just kind of working out an idea and just the composition and the dynamic between the two, between the group of people, and the story develops. It's a lot like writing a book or any kind of a story, and just sort of as you move along and try to develop the characters. But it was always about, you know, being on the road and meeting someone on the road and who you meet along the way. This is The Chosen One. It's probably the one that's the least furthest along out of all these that I've started. It has a long way to go, but you can kind of see where how I get started. When I first start painting, I'll just use a lot of turpentine and just start drawing like I would draw with a pencil, and just kind of block it in. And at first, it's a very light washes, and just trying to figure out where everything's gonna go and just start building it up and trying to get it all together. And it just really just emerges. So I'll just keep putting on more and more paint, and eventually I'll switch over to oil instead of, and get away from the turpentine and just use oil and medium and build up glazes and color that way. And light sources, trying to figure out where the light's gonna be. And so I can, you know, the challenge is always to see it, and, you know, for me to see it form and the real shape emerge. The politics you can kind of put away and avoid, and I think with politics, as with my art, there's always maybe lots of levels and there's stuff going on behind the scenes that you really don't know about. I think there's probably an element of that in my work. There's stuff going on maybe behind the scenes and my own agenda on some of these, and it's kind of interesting to kind of sneak some of that in there. this is called Proliferation. And here we have the American schoolgirl with this nuclear bomb on her back. And she thinks she's getting ready to take off. And again, these kids are all just sort of waiting to see what happens. You've got a lot of light coming in. It's obvious it's about ready to explode. And it talks about just American exports, I would guess you'd say. And, you know, and these innocent girls, again, don't know what's going to hit them.
There's so much homogeny in the world, and certainly in the United States. And I think that's one thing I rally against in my work, and it's just being the outsider and standing up for that and against the mainstream.
This is Hanging by a Thread. I think it's just, it's about exposing yourself and just being out and having fun while doing it. And this is a painting I've been thinking about for a long time. I didn't necessarily have her in a golf course, but once I got her going, it seemed like a logical place for her to be flying a kite. So just about putting yourself out there and exposing yourself and not really caring what people think.
You know, I'm sure there was a time when I wasn't quite willing to put everything out there, but I would put it in a painting even though I wasn't willing to talk about it. And if people figured it out, I may say, yeah, that's pretty close. Or I may just say, no, that's not right. It depends on who it is I'm talking to, I suppose. Part of the fun for me is to figure out where it's gonna go. It's like, yeah, that's a good idea, but you know, not really knowing what's gonna happen in the end. And that's part of the process for me, is what does this mean to me? And I kind of figure that out as I go along, and how can I make this work? What does it mean? And it's also usually a lot of surprises when that happens. You know, I don't always know what's gonna happen. To me, it's more about creating it and seeing what's gonna happen.